people keep saying I'm too expensive. They're not booking me. They say it costs too much money. My competitor is charging less, so they're getting all the business. And I'm here to tell you the reason why that's happening to you. So the reason why is because you're not communicating the value of what you offer in an effective way. And there are several ways that that might be happening to you, right? So number one is you're not marketing to the right audience, right? So if you have this expensive, valuable program, but you're marketing to people who, number one, don't value that service or just don't have the money to pay for it, which some would argue that, you know, if people really know that they need your service and that will help them make more money, they'll find the money, right? So number two, you don't have the right offer. So this has to do with communicating the value, right? Your offer should be a no-brainer where people, you know, even if someone supposedly is cheaper, it's very clear they're getting more value from you and you're going to help them solve their problem. So the way you're wording the offer, the way you've priced the offer, the way you're presenting it, right? Maybe in your sales calls, you're not doing a good enough job of communicating that value on your website, landing pages, social media. You just aren't explaining it in a way that shows the value to your customer. So another one might be you need to charge more, right? If we are presented with two products and one is $10, the other one's $1,000, which one are we gonna think is better, right? I recently shopped for a new office chair. And this was kind of something in my mind, right? I'm like, I want a really good chair. I want something that's going to be supportive and last for a long time. And I didn't buy the cheapest chair because I assume it's going to be a cheap, crappy chair, right? So I also didn't want to buy, you know, a $3,000 chair because at some point, you know, I'm thinking, I just don't really need a $3,000 chair. So I bought one kind of in the middle. I wanted to make sure it was going to be high quality and last for a while and be comfortable. So, you know, think about your service. Is it coming across as cheap because of the price, right? And it seems counterintuitive that you should charge more when people are telling you you're too expensive, but that's because it's a perceived value thing, right? And that's probably not the right customer. Anyway. Lastly, how is your branding communicating to your people that your service is professional, is worth it, is going to help them? And this could come across in, you know, visuals on your website, social media. If you have a brick and mortar, your sign, the decorations in your office, the outside appearance of your building. Also, the words that you have written anywhere, you know, website, ads, your sales calls, how your customers are greeted when they come through the door, all of those things communicate who you are. That's all part of your brand. So, and that's kind of what brings together all of those other things, right? The right audience, the right price, how you communicate your offer, those are all part of your brand as well. So if you feel like you're not doing so great in those four areas and you'd like some help, reach out to me. This is also part of my 6 steps to scale your business program, which will be launching later this year in 2022. If you'd like more information about that, visit workstorycreative.com. You can join the waiting list for now, depending on when you're watching this video. If it's past 2022, just go to the website, find the information, and join the program, where you'll get more in-depth help with scaling your business. See you in the next video.